Hey everybody, my name is Dave Kiss, and I'm hanging with my dog Dexter back here, and we've been building on a React and Redux app for a little bit now, and still learning through a whole lot of this stuff because it's pretty complex, or at least complicated, a lot of moving parts, and we've hit the part finally where it's time to make some API calls from Redux, or from our actions that we're creating, and implementing that has just been a pain. Trying to figure out who's doing what approach, and should we use thunks, and all these words that I've never even heard of before. And so I finally sat down yesterday and figured it all out with the help of redux-saga, which is a package that super nice way of implementing all of this flow, and it feels very much in the same realm as how Redux and React all work. So I wanted to make this quick video I don't know how quick it's gonna be, to be honest, but to share with you how this stuff works. It was kind of difficult to figure out at first. A lot of this stuff is kind of technical, and written, the way that it's written about is also kind of hard to digest, but I want to make this video to make it a little bit easier to understand exactly how to get this stuff implemented. So this video assumes you already know a bit about React and Redux and Webpack, and if you're not familiar with those things, this tutorial is probably not for you, so you should go back and start learning some of those things first, and once you start feeling comfortable, come on back and we will help you out from there. So without further ado, let's dive in and write some code and figure out how to make API calls from Redux. So just a quick introduction to what this app is doing. We have basically this lesson builder, and all it really does, we have one button here, add lesson, and we're going one way, just adding a lesson to this course. Every time you click this button, what happens is it's attached to our create lesson action, which we have mapped to our props through map dispatch to props, and we bound our action creator for create lesson to the dispatch. So that's a mouthful. Basically what happens, you click the button and it says, okay, what should I do when I click the button? Well, let's create the lesson. Create the lesson says, okay, we are going to look at our props and fire the, or dispatch the create lesson action, which is bound to props here. And from there, if we go into our actual actions, we can go and see that create lesson will add the lesson to our state and return the new lesson that we've just created here. So that's a long way of saying this button, all it does is just add things to the web page. And we could see that there's new one here, new one here, and every single time it's firing off that action and adding a new lesson to our state. But it would be helpful that if we actually clicked add lesson, that it made a actual lesson in a database and not in just your state. So what we want to do here is call an API so that every time we click add lesson, it's creating a new entry in the database. So it's actually associated with this user who is creating these lessons. And when they come back to their account, there are the lessons that they created, as you might expect, and not just a blank state or empty local storage or whatever. So that's what we're gonna do. We wanna hook up this add lesson button to an API call that actually creates these lessons here. So let's get started.